In order to irrigate your landscape efficiently and automatically, it is essential to use a correctly programmed irrigation controller. Many controllers in use today are improperly programmed or ill-equipped to efficiently water a typical landscape. Simply programming a controller to run for a few minutes 3 or 4 days a week can lead to unhealthy plants and turf or wasted water from runoff. Advancements in technology have led to the development of smart irrigation controllers. This category of controller can make real-time, intelligent irrigation decisions. As with any computer, a smart controller will first need to be programmed correctly in order for it to do its job. Otherwise, it will be a stupid controller. To accomplish this, there are four questions you need to answer. How much water is required for the plant material to remain healthy? How much water is each irrigation zone delivering over a set amount of time? What is the soil type, and how quickly does it absorb water? And what are the current and historic weather conditions in your area? To answer these questions, you'll need to gather some data specific to your landscape. This includes plant type and maturity, number of zones, including the precipitation rate of the heads or emitters in each zone, the slope of the site, sun exposure, soil type, geographic location, and more. To get started, you will need to figure out what type of plants you're irrigating as well as their average root depth. Since different types of plants and turf have different water requirements, knowing how much water to deliver is a critical piece of information. Local universities, libraries, and nurseries can be a great resource for learning this information. You can also search online for a regional plant guide. If you had the opportunity, it's a good idea to landscape with plants that are indigenous to your area. You'll find them much easier to care for. Keep in mind that for maximum water efficiency, your irrigation zones should not contain plants with contrasting water requirements or areas of contrasting microclimates. Once the plant watering requirements are determined, you'll need to decide the best method for irrigation. There are a variety of rotors, sprays, and drip emission devices available, but they vary greatly in their precipitation rates. So for the controller to calculate run times, you'll need to enter in the correct application rate for each specific zone. There are many tools available online that can help you determine these values, including the Ewing smartphone app. Next, you'll need to know the texture of your soil. Soil texture refers to the amount of clay, silt, or sand that your soil contains and will determine its water absorption rate and holding capacity. For example, soils consisting predominantly of clay will have a slower water intake rate and a higher holding capacity than soils consisting mostly of sand. The slow intake rate means that runoff can occur much more quickly when irrigating a clay-rich soil. Programming the soil type will allow the controller to make adjustments to reduce the runoff. There are many combinations of soil types, so performing a soil test is the best way to help you determine the type you have. A soil test will also tell you what nutrients your soil may be lacking. Local weather information will also help the controller make adjustments to irrigation cycles, improving efficiency. Some smart controllers use pre-programmed historic weather information to make intelligent decisions on how to irrigate in your climate. You'll also want to know how much direct sunlight is available each day by zone. Finally, the addition of weather sensors plays a large part in making a smart controller smart. These types of sensors include rain, temperature, solar radiation, soil moisture, wind speed, and irrigation flow. After you've collected all of your data, you can begin programming your smart controller. Now, this just covers the basics. There are more advanced settings for programming a smart controller. If you would like to learn more, attend one of our live seminars. Class information can be found online at ewingirrigation.com.